In recent years, Asian American stars like Ali Wong, Hasan Minhaj, and Joe Coy have taken the comedy world by storm. Today, Coy is one of the biggest names in comedy.
I'm half white, half Filipino, which means my dad was in the military.
He recently met up with Coy at the Hollywood Improv. He said coming up, he was often told that broader audiences wouldn't get Filipino-themed jokes.
If I send my son to school with a Tupperware container, he goes to school with a clear bowl, and it's got a blue lid, and it says Tupperware on the lid. My mom's Tupperware, usually an empty Cool Whip container.
That joke took me over the top. What I like is not only did Filipino-Americans relate to it, but then everyone was relating to it.
The 50-year-old is no overnight success story, doing stand-up for 25 years before his big break.
There were people that opened for me that were getting specials. I'm like, what is it that I'm doing wrong that I'm not getting looked at? Like, what is it?
Did you ever ask yourself, I wonder if it's because I'm Asian American, or was that not even a problem?
Of course that was in my mind.
Coy finally broke through with his hit Netflix special, Live from Seattle.
When I found out Rob Schneider was half Filipino, it's like, oh, okay, well, Rob's Filipino. Okay, I can be a comedian too, because he made it. That means I can make it, because it's hard. Try not to cry right now. But it's just like, that's what you want, right? You want to inspire. It's like, we're here, we're all here.
That's what I'm talking about. Your mom yelled at me. That's all my mom did was yell at me. That was the only language my mom spoke was yell. Ha? What? Say it again. Say it again. Say it. What did you say, Jose? What did you say? Turn around. Turn around, Jose. That's the only language my mom talked. Yell. Ha? Wait. When did you do it? Where? Where did you go? Huh? What? Did you lose your lunchbox? I remember when I lost my lunchbox one time. Holy shit. That's how my mom disciplined.
It relates through to all of us.
She never, like, physically touched you. She verbally attacked you. That's when she went after you. She'd break you down in words.
Oh,
interrogation. 2.5 hours of yelling. What? Where's your lunchbox, Joseph? Where did you put it? I don't know. What do you mean you don't know? Where? Where did you go? You go from house to school, school to house. Where the fuck did you lose it? What, you just take your lunchbox and put it anywhere? Oh, I don't know where. I don't know where anything is. I don't know where. Where's your lunchbox, Joseph? Where? Where did you put it? I don't know. Then she'll just repeat what I said in a stupid voice. How do you not know, Joseph? How?
No, Mom. What do you say?
Tell me where it is. 2 hours of that. Where? Huh? She wants me to have snot coming out of my mouth and then breathe it in at the same time. That's when she's happy. That's when my mom knows she got me. That's when she walks up to me. Okay, breathe, Joseph, breathe, my God. Breathe, my God, Joseph, breathe. It's just a lunchbox. Then she's got to embarrass me. Then she's got to put my lunch in a Tupperware container. That's how she embarrasses me. She always says, I'm going to put your lunch in a Tupperware container.
Better not lose it.
Why?
Better not lose
it. I don't want to go to school. Why not? Because I don't want to go to school with my lunch in one of your Tupperware. That shit's embarrassing.
Is it?
If I send my son to school with a Tupperware container, he goes to school with a clear bowl, and it's got a blue lid, and it says Tupperware on the lid. I should be proud to go to school with that shit. My mom's Tupperware?
Yeah, I'd be cool to go to school with that.
Usually an empty Cool Whip container?
Yeah.
money when she put it in an empty Neapolitan ice cream container. Oh, yeah. On the red handle, she put my homework and my lunch and looked like a fucking briefcase. Like, what the fuck?
The red handle.
Lunch in a food container. That shit is so embarrassing. And then she goes, grab a Sharpie so I can write your name on the label. Like someone else has a Cool Whip container lunchbox. I'm pretty sure I'm the only one with a Cool Whip container lunchbox. You never know, Joseph. No, I know. I'm walking around the lunchroom looking for a place to sit. My Cool Whip container lunchbox. All the other kids are looking at me. Whoa. Your mom's gonna let you eat Cool Whip.
Cool Whip is great, bro.
I don't know what's inside it. Little kid down at the lunch table. My Cool Whip container lunchbox. All these other kids are trading lunches in front of me. Yeah. But no one wants to trade for the mystery bucket. My mouth is watering. So you see all these delicious trades going down. I'll give you my turkey and cheddar cheese sandwich for that peanut butter and jelly. Oh. I'll give you my chocolate chip cookies for those Pringles. I'll give you my chocolate milk for that Gatorade.
What's in the box?
I'm gonna get all of them.
What's in it?
Does anyone want mango? It's so good, mango. You get to keep the container.
Wow.
Some kid was like, what the fuck is mango? I had to explain it to him. It's these little round green beans, and it sits on top of a bed of rice. And if you dig deep enough, you might find a shrimp or two. Some other kid was like, what the fuck is that bag of sauce next to it? Batiste. Filipino fish sauce. It really accents the flavor of the mungo. Don't spill it on your shirt, you smell like pussy all day. My mom had to raise us on her own.
Same.
Did that shit on her own. Tough as shit. Sometimes a little too tough. Like, it was borderline illegal, but.
Yeah.
It sucked. She never took us to the doctor. My mom never took us to the doctor. My mom raised us like we were still in the Philippines. She tried to cure everything at home. Like a real Filipino woman. You had to die to go to the hospital. Shit. My mom cured everything with Vicks Vaporub. I should have died 9 times when I was a kid. That's abuse. There's one time I thought I had pneumonia. The mom, I think I have pneumonia. She goes, I'll put extra Vicks on your body. Just rub it everywhere, Joseph. Rub it on the bottom of the foot.
And then the
sock on the foot. And then the pneumonia will come out of the foot. Just smothered in fucking bits. I should have called the cops. Come on, never hit us. She just scared us a lot. She loved to curse. And she used to flex like that. She didn't do that shit. She brought that to America. Anyone that does this shit, hey, my mom saw that shit. She did it to all of us. You know how embarrassing that is? To get pumped by a 4'8" Asian woman? The fucking mom, get out of the goddamn food line. Get out of the food line. I'm not even in the food
I never did that to you.
I used to cry. I used to cry and tell my mom, Mom, when I have kids, I'm never going to do what you do to me, to my kids. And my mom looked at me. I swear to God, she put her hand on my shoulder and she goes, Joseph, promise me, okay? Never have kids.
Like, damn, Mom!
Shit on my drink. Yo, I'm telling you this, man. I became a comedian, which is totally against the grain when you have a Filipino mom. If you have a Filipino mom, that is not the career choice you're supposed to have. Filipino moms predetermine what their kids are supposed to be when they grow up. And you know I'm not making this shit
up. I think all moms do that.
There's a lot of Filipinos in here right now that are nurses.
I don't know if the same in the UK.
Today is a good day to get injured at a show. Because there will be a nurse in here like, oh my God, put a cold compress on the head. Elevate the beat, elevate the beat. What the fuck is elevate? Just leave. Leave. Are you stupid?
Oh my God.
Elevate.
And I'm not, hey, look, I'm not shitting on you for being a nurse. That's a great job, great benefits, good money. I'm just saying, it wasn't your dream. That was your Filipino mom's dream. My mom wanted me to be a nurse. Are you fucking kidding me? Filipino moms shit on their kids' dreams. And you know I'm not lying. You know I'm not lying. They can't have a dream. What are you talking about, dream? I told my mom I wanted to be a comedian. She cried. Why? Why do you want to be a comedian? Your aunties are nurses? Your cousins are nurses? Do you see any clowns in this family? Do you?
The whole world told me this.
She had my dream right there. Just looked at me and went like this, Joseph, who told you you were funny?
Damn.
It wasn't me.
It's very good, man. It helps me clear out your own.
Thank you.